Hello, I'm Vanya Gröger, also known as Nechtan, and this video is a drum-focused review of the album Ordo Ad Cau from Mayhem. Enjoy! My last review was about Dimmu Borgir's Puritanical Euphoric Misanthropia, and at this point I would like to thank you for your responses and your feedback on that video. Well, but now we have here kind of the complete antithesis to the Dimmu Borgir album. This is mayhem, this is pure madness. Well, I don't really know where to start with this album, but in general, this album basically equals this. But before I go into more detail about why I think this is the case, let's start talking about how this album looks on the outside. First thing you will notice is that this album comes in a nice metal case, which is very metal, I think, and it makes the impression of something of high quality inside. When you pull out the CD, you can see just this. There's no title on it, nothing whatsoever, just a red jewel case and some abstract whatever. You can't really see what it is supposed to be or not. And this is kind of how the rest of the booklet looks like. I can show you one page, because when you have seen one page, you have basically seen them all here. Lyrics on one side and the rest just this confusing, abstract, whatever stuff. When it comes to the information contained in this booklet, it's also extremely minimalistic. There are no big acknowledgements or thank yous or whatever, no personal notes whatsoever. There are just the song lyrics, and then at the very end, just a short list of Attila, vocals, Blasphema, guitars and bass, Hellhammer drums, and Necrobutcher, bass. Yeah, and that's basically it. There are also no pictures of band members inside, so nothing really interesting to see. And in the very end, there's also the information when this album was recorded. It was recorded in the end of 2006 and released in April 2007. The only thing that is that stands a little bit out, that is a bit more than just plain information, is one mysterious sentence that I really can't make any sense of. So if you know what that means, please comment below. It says, "Tubes and fuck-ups on a wise birth giver handled by Mr. Knut Walle," who's also the guy who mixed this album. Yeah, besides that, nothing personal whatsoever. At the beginning, I mentioned that this album equals a middle finger, and this is mainly because it is so different from its predecessor, Chimera. Chimera was an album with a relatively clean production that gained a wider audience, and it's maybe the most mainstream sounding Mayhem album. And after that, I think most people thought, okay, now Mayhem, they have found their style and the oncoming albums will be like that. But with Ordo Ad Cau, they completely destroyed that. So this album basically destroys everything that Chimera may have built up before. I think Mayhem is a band, they just don't give a shit what other people think. And they also don't fear to disappoint parts of their fan base with completely unexpected material. And I think this is a very positive thing. They are, as far as I can judge, extremely independent from what their fan base may expect from them. So, let's start talking about the sound and production of this album. I want to start with something that Hellhammer wrote, and he stated, "The production sounds necro as fuck, but that's the way we wanted it, this time." And this is actually a very accurate description. So, first of all, the drum sound. The drum sound, I don't want to say natural, because it's actually more than natural. They sound so raw that I think that a normal drum video on my channel has a better sound. According to Hellhammer, the drums were not even EQ'd. And this is a very strange thing, to record drums and not even EQ them. Also, the drums sound extremely dry and just like, yeah, like they were recorded with some cheap microphones and went straight into the mixer, and they did nothing else with the drums. Sometimes the toms even sound as if they are clipping, so this is really as raw as it can get. Also, the overall sound of the drums themselves is pretty strange. The toms and cymbals seem to be all very big and deep, while the snare sounds very, very thin and flat, which is a very stark contrast and makes an overall very strange impression. I think there's also not much compression on anything, if any at all, and only the bass drums are triggered. When it comes to the volume of the individual parts of the drum set, I would like to mention that this is a very typical Hellhammer-like sound, because his right cymbal and his hi-hats are very loud compared to the rest of the drum set, which is pretty uncommon in modern metal productions. But the drum sound is not the only thing that is weird. The guitar sound is also very extreme, because it is a bit bass-heavy, and also has tons and tons of reverb. I think I have never heard an album with so much reverb on the guitars before. So this all contributes to a very strange and also very dark atmosphere on this album. But one element that is also very crucial in this is the singer. So on this album you can hear Attila. He was also the singer on the much older album Die Mysteries Dom Satanas. After that he was replaced by Maniac, but for this album he came back. I don't know if I can actually call Attila a very good singer, but he's a true genius when it comes to experimenting with his voice. You can hear an amazing variety of very unlikely and strange sounds that he produces with his voice, and is just amazing. So from deepest growls over very strange sounding whispers, you can also hear insane inhale sounds and very weird super high pitch shrieking, just everything. So I like his performance very much on this album, and it really plays a large part in the atmosphere that is created. So, I talked a lot about the sound on this album, in particular the drum sound, but now let's get into more detail about the drumming itself. First of all, the drummer on this album is Hellhammer. I think everyone should actually know who this is, because Hellhammer is an absolute legend in the Norwegian black metal scene, and he has recorded so many albums, it is absolutely unbelievable. So on this album, Hellhammer really proves what an amazing drummer he is. He plays very versatile in general and extremely fast. I think this is really one of the albums with one of the fastest double bass and blast beats I have ever heard. It is absolutely insane. This being said, the drumming on this album is not perfect. Absolutely not. He does not sound like a drum machine. There's a very strong human element in his drumming. And I think this also has a very simple reason. Not only the sound is very raw, also the whole production process was very raw. According to Hellhammer, he recorded this album in 2.5 evenings, which is, I think, not very much time. And I am pretty sure there was no post-editing involved in this album. So everything you hear on this sounds like he just sat down on his drum kit and just played the song in one take, and this is the result. I think Hellhammer has a very unique set of skills for a metal drummer, and a very unique approach to his metal drumming. He also uses a variety of very uncommon drumming techniques for metal drummers, for example the push-pull technique that I also use. And this allows him to do many things that other drummers can't do, but at the same time many standard things, for example blast beats, just sound very different when he plays them. A very good example of how he sounds very different from others can be heard on the song, for example, Great Work of Ages. During the blast beats, you will notice that he seems to hit not very hard, and I think he seems to play the blast beat more with a jazz-like attitude. Normally, metal drummers try to sound like a drum computer with the blast beats, but this sounds much more kind of laid back. It's hard to describe, so just go and listen to it for yourselves. So in general, he does play tight and his macro timing is flawless, but when you look into the little details and the micro timing, you just see that he is not perfect, and I find this very sympathetic. So he didn't go through all the process of doing 10,000 takes until it was perfect or post-editing stuff. He just played the songs very good, recorded them, and just took this as the end result. So if you want to get a little impression of how extreme his drumming is on this album, listen to the song Entai. I think there's also an official music video of this song on YouTube. Well, apart from the almost unreal drumming, the rest of the album is equally strange. The songs have very little structure or very irregular structures, and many parts are not repeated at all. And also, there's a complete lack of melodies that stay in your head. So there are no nice melodies or harmonies. Everything just sounds very alien and extremely dark and depressive. So this album, Ordo Ad Cao, really lives up to its title, which means, roughly translated, from order to chaos. By the way, Ordo Ad Cao is Latin and grammatically incorrect, so there's actually no real correct translation of that. And this is kind of symptomatic for this album. I mean, the album title is just wrong, but this is Mayhem. I think they just say, fuck you, we don't care if the album title is wrong. This is chaos. So, this. So, all in all, this album is extremely unique. I think it is one of these albums that you can either love or hate, and there's nothing in between. In general, I think it is completely amazing that Mayhem can put out different albums that sound completely different from each other. On the one hand, we have this album, Ordo Ad Cao, which sounds necro as fuck, and on the other hand, we have, for example, Grand Declaration of War, which is the epitome of electronic perversion. So, all in all, I really enjoy listening to this album, but because it has such a depressive aura, I can't listen to it too much, because it just drags me down too much. But if you like extreme music and you like black metal, I can definitely recommend buying this album. You can find the Amazon link down below in the description. So, did you know this album before, and what do you think about this album? Feel free to leave a comment down below. Well, that's it for today. If you enjoyed the video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, like this video of course, you can also like my Facebook page and follow me on Twitter. And if you want to buy this awesome hoodie, check out my Spreadshirt shop. The links are down below in the description. See you next time.